Along the way, it's going to worsen things because a lot of people are going to be discontented, are going to be harassed, and they're going to be very angry. Right now, people are angry. You see that every day, every night in the news. People can't go to work. People are hungry. People are expressing their discontent. You can see that. Now, you give them something else that would worsen the situation. So it doesn't answer the question. Instead of generating support, no, in the fight against terrorism, you deflect the approach to the critical question of what about our rights, no? So kaysa tama yan, dapat ganito ang gawin ng gobyerno natin kasi talagang ina-attack yung mga civilian, yung mga terrorists. Hindi eh. So hindi siya nasasagot, and then you don't get the support of the citizenry. Tapos nagkakaroon pa ng disgusto, and then na-undermine pa yung democratic institutions kasi inaagawan mo yung power ng mga huwes na mag-issue ng mga warrants of arrest, no, sa isang very small group of executive officials. Ang kailangan diyan, we have been saying this all along. Labanan natin terorismo, the real terrorists, all right? Mm. Secondly, how do you do that? Kasi ang dami na nating laws eh, may safeguards daw. Biro naman, dami safeguards, may Anti-Torture Act, may Anti-Disappearance Act, may Miranda Rights sa Constitution. Meron, party tayo sa 11 of the 12 International Conventions on Human Rights. Meron pang ang karil na tinatawag, yung bilateral agreement. Eh bakit tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung violations? Nakikita naman natin, wala napaparusahan. So ang sinasabi namin, professional, competent, consistent, scientific investigation, prosecution, and conviction of the real terrorists without any political consideration. Without ang tawag namin dito, yung weaponization of the law. Don't weaponize the law against your opponents, whether perceived or real, no?